In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the God of hope give you the fullness of peace, and may the Lord of life be always with you. Our opening hymn is, on the first page, Yes, I shall arise and return to my Father, the first five verses only.
So you hold on.
my brothers and sisters, and forgives our sins. Let us pray, asking God to gather our brother, innocent Otto, a wind to himself. Lord our God, the death of our brother innocent recalls our human condition and the brevity of our lives on earth. But for those who believe, death is not the end, nor does it destroy the bonds that you forge in our lives. We share the faith of your Son's disciples and the hope of the children of God. Bring the light of Christ's resurrection to this time of testing and pain, as we pray for innocent and for those who love him, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please sit down for the second week. I come to thee once more, my God.
In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster, but they are at peace. If they experienced punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction, great was their blessings be. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them like a holocaust. When the time comes for his visitation, they will shine out. As sparks run through the stubble, so will they. They shall judge nations, rule over peoples, and the Lord will be their king forever. They who put trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love. For grace and mercy await those he has chosen. This is the word of the Lord.
Innocent Otto Ewing. For we are sustained by the sure hope that he will rise again with all those who have died in Christ. We give you thanks for all the good things you granted your servant, in this mortal life are signs for us of your goodness and the communion of the saints in Christ. May be opened for this your chosen one. And in our turn, may we also be comforted by the words of faith until we hasten to meet Christ, who may all be forever with the Lord and with our dear one. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please sit. The next hymn is number 3.
Jesus.
We shall listen to the second reading now.
This mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples, and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day, it will be said, see, this is our God, in whom we hope for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hope. We exalt and we rejoice that he has saved us. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please rise and
so that all people might be saved and pass from death into a new life. Listen to our prayers. Look with love on your people who mourn and pray for their dead husband and father, innocent, Arthur Edwin. Lord Jesus, you alone are holy and compassionate. Forgive our brother his sins. By dying, you open the gates of life for those who believe in you. Do not let our brother innocent be parted from you, but by your glorious power, give him light, joy, and peace in heaven, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Please sit for the next hymn, number 5, Rock of Ages.
Let's be God, my soul with me. Let the walls around the throne, from the rivers and the flow, we will see the God who cures, save me from the tilt and fall. Of the labor of my hands, stand for
not to deliver it into the hands of the enemy,
not to forget it forever, but to command thy holy angels to receive it and to conduct it to the heavenly country, that since it had believed and hoped in thee, it may not suffer the pains of hell, but possess eternal joys. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please sit for the next hymn, number 6. I need thee every hour.
I need.
Son but gave him up to benefit us all, we may be certain after such a gift that he will not refuse anything he can give. Could anyone accuse those that God has chosen? When God accused, could anyone condemn? Could Jesus Christ? No, he not only died for us, he rose up from the dead, and there at God's right hand, he stands and pleads for us. Nothing, therefore, can come between us and the love of Christ. Even if we are troubled or worried, or being persecuted, or lacking food or clothes, or being threatened or being attacked, these are the trials through which we triumph by the power of him who loved us. For I am certain of this, neither death or life, nor angel, nor prince, nothing that exists, nothing still to come, not any power, no height or depth, not any created thing can come between us and the love of God made visible in Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
blessing.
Brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them, like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teaching, that any of us who are left alive until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of God, the voice of the archangel will call out the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and then those of us who are still alive will be taken up into the clouds, together with them, to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as this, you should comfort one another. The word of the Lord. Lord, in the land of the living.
I believe your eyes shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
Oh,
please run into my father's house. If they were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated.
First of all, on behalf of the Egwin family, Mrs. Egwin, her children, and all our family members, let me welcome all of you to this service this evening. This hall is practically full. A lot of people here, you have come to show your solidarity to this family. You are all welcome. Before the service began, I was handed this information that we have here in our midst. Two honorable members, distinguished members of the Imo State House of Assembly. I would like to recognize them and welcome them especially. Right Honorable Amara Iwanyam, Deputy Speaker, Imo State House of Assembly. I hope that is the correct name. All right. And the Chief Whip, Imo State House of Assembly, Honorable Chigozie Maneri. Stand up and see. Thank you very much. Thank you for coming all the way to show your solidarity to this family, even though the final rites will be taking place in Imo State. You still felt it opportune to come here and join us in this initial service. Next, on behalf of all of us who are here this evening, I wish to offer heartfelt condolences to Mrs. Egwin and her children. I think I see some grandchildren as well, and other family members. Please accept our sympathy and our heartfelt condolences on the passing of your beloved husband and father and grandfather, the Honorable Barrister Innocent Arthur Egwin, at just 60 years of age, which is a rather unfortunate, to say the least. 60 years. It's not ripe old age, it is still the prime of life. So for God to have called him at this time, at that age, he again accept our heartfelt condolences. We are gathered here this evening. I want to believe that most of us here are Christians. And we believe in the Word of God, the Holy Bible. During the read from that good book, the Holy Bible, we read several passages. This evening we have read six from the Old Testament and the New Testament. We sing hymns. That's why it is called Service of Songs. To say prayers,
All of these things are trying to remind us of something that we already know if we are Christians. That is the fact that for those who are disciples of Christ, death is not the end of life. Death is a transition, a passage from this life here on earth to another life in the presence of God, the life of heaven. That is what all our readings and songs and prayers have been reminding us of this evening. And the message is directed primarily to the Aguil family. Your father, your husband, your grandfather, they have departed this life. But he lives on. He lives on in the life hereafter. I want to believe that he was a disciple of Christ, that he believed in Christ, and he lived his life in Christ. If he did that, then the promises that Jesus made to his disciples must be fulfilled in him. Jesus made a lot of promises in the Gospel to his disciples, having to do with life and death. Just a while ago, we read from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 14, where Jesus told his disciples that there were many rooms in his Father's house, and he was going there, ahead of them, to prepare a place for them. And I would come back to take them with him, so that where he is, they would be also. What Jesus told his disciples then still applies to us who are disciples today. There are many rooms, if you like, many dwelling places. Indeed, some versions of the Bible call them mansions in our Father's house in heaven, prepared for us by no less a person than the Son of God himself, our Lord Jesus Christ. Those rooms are ours because we are God's children, and God's children must inherit what God has prepared for them. So, our brother, innocent, has gone to take possession of his own in our Father's house. Not that we would have wished for him to go at this time, certainly not. If we had our way, we would want him to be able to still be around between the 70s, 80s, 90s. But then who are we to challenge God? Who are we to question God? Who can stand up and say, God, why do you do this? Some people say, it is not fair. With God, who knows, who can say what is fair and what is not? As mere creatures, we can do no more to say, thy will be done. God's will be done, no matter what we human beings prefer. All I can ask and pray for is that God will give you the grace to accept his will. God will give you his grace to live with his will. so that God's way will not crush you, will not cause you to lose your faith and to lose hope. One of our readings this evening, the fifth, St. Paul said that to the Thessalonians. Say, I want you, brothers, I'll tell you something, that you do not grieve like those who do not have hope. You should not grieve like those who do not have hope. You have hope that your loved one, your father, your husband, is going to be with the Lord. Let that be your consolation. I'm not saying that it will take away all the sadness, all the sorrow. Like I said earlier, all of us would have wished for him to live much, much, much longer than that. But let God's grace, with our own lives, may God continue to provide for you. The vacuum that has been left with the departure of innocent, may God fill it in your lives.
Amen.
Two of our readings here talked about God wiping the tears from our eyes. One was about God wiping the tears of those who have died. Another was about wiping the tears from those who mourn. So that God will wipe the tears from your eyes. So we go on praying for the happy and eternal repose of innocence. Believe it or not, even though he died so young, we have reason to give thanks to God. St. Paul said, in all circumstances, we should give thanks to God. He did not exclude death or bereavement. I think we should thank God that there was never such a man as innocent out of the way, that God created, that God made it possible for his path and yours to cross. That God kept him for 60 years. As I said earlier, 60 years is not a lot of years, but you know that there are many people, particularly these are horrible Nigerians, that don't make it to 60. You know that?
Yeah.
In Nigeria, the life expectancy is about 52 years. I'm not mistaken. So 60 years, it's not wonderful, but it's something to thank God. That God preserved him. You enjoyed him for that number of years. I don't know how long you were married to him, how long you knew him, but you had him for that number of years. Your children had him for different numbers of years depending on their age. Thank God for that. And thank God for all that he was able to achieve. He was a member of the Imo State House of Assembly. That is, he was a man who came out to serve his people. It's not easy to want to serve people in Nigeria and go into politics. Politicians, it's a wild place, very in the jungle. To come out, stick out your neck. I want to serve the people. So we thank God that God inspired him to do that. And he did that for a number of years. God will count those years to his credit, those years of service, because we're here on earth primarily to serve God and to serve people. We're not here to serve ourselves, or to serve our immediate family, or our special interest group. We are here to serve God's people. Barrister Ebin came out to serve the people of Imo State. I believe God will count that, give credit for doing that. But most of all, I thank God that he was a child of God, a Christian, a believer, washed in the blood of Christ. Because that is what gives us reason to. Son of God, who came to destroy sin and death, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Word of God, who delivered us from the fear of death, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
crucified Lord, forsaken in death, raised in glory, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord Jesus, gentle shepherd, who bring rest to our souls, give peace to innocent again forever. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bless those who mourn and are in pain. Bless innocent again's family and friends who are gathered here today. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
My dear friends, brothers and sisters in Christ, our true home is heaven. Therefore, let us pray to our Heavenly Father as Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
Lord Jesus, our Redeemer, you willingly gave yourself up to death so that all might be saved and pass from death to life. We humbly ask you to comfort your servants in their grief and receive innocent out of a wind into the arms of your mercy. You are mercy itself. By dying, you unlock the gates of life for those who believe in you. Forgive innocent his sins, and grant him a place of happiness, light, and peace in the kingdom of your glory forever.
Amen.
Blessed are those who have died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labors, for their good deeds go with them. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
And let the face of thy shine upon him.
May he rest in peace.
Amen.
May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed to the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing, the peace, and the consolation of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you all and remain with you forever.
I say thank you on his behalf for coming today. To Father, thank you for seeing us in this Mass. To the choir members, thank you. And to everyone, I say thank you. Thanks for coming and have a great evening. Thank you.
Thank you. Can join.